Hi, I am Victor Costa and I'm going to present the poster Improved Evolution of Generative Adversarial Networks. Generative Adversarial Networks is a model that consists of two deep neural networks, one generator and one discriminator, that are trained together to build strong generative models. GANs achieved impressive results mostly on the generation of high-quality images. However, the training of GAN is hard and suffers from stability issues such as the mode collapse and vanishing gradient. To overcome these issues, we propose COEGAN, a model that uses neural evolution and competitive coevolution to drive the training and evolution of GAMs. In this work, we propose COEGAN version 2, an extension of COEGAN that incorporates new mechanisms into the model. So, in summary, our proposal consists of add the possibility to choose between different normalization strategies, so we can use batch normalization, spectral normalization, or no normalization in layers. Also, we incorporate the use of RaSGAN as alternative model for GAMs to train generators and discriminators. And finally, we use the loss function of RaSGAN as the thickness functions for generators and discriminators. In COEGAN version 2, we keep the proposal of COEGAN to encode the representation of the neural networks through a sequence of genes composing the genome. It also uses two separated populations to represent discriminators and generators and pairs individuals from these populations to apply the GAN algorithm and learn the trainable internal parameters. In COEGAN version 2, we use the loss functions of RaSGAN both in the training and as fitness function for generators and discriminators. In this way, we avoid the costly computation of the FID score for every individual at each generation used in the first version of COEGAN, making use of the same losses obtained during the GAN training step. We also introduce in COEGAN version 2 random normalization for layers. So, layers can use batch, spectral normalization, or no normalization strategy. We also incorporate in this model the option to choose layers for generators using convolution combined with upsampling or transpose convolution. You can see in the poster an example of the genome of a discriminator and a generator. To validate our proposal, we conduct some experiments using the Passion and Minis dataset. We compare our proposal COEGAN version 2 with the original COEGAN proposal and also with non-evolutionary GAMs. We applied the evolutionary algorithm of COEGAN in the first 50 generations and used the best individual to be trained for 50 more generations. The non-evolutionary GAMs are based on DC GAN and are built with an equivalent setup for a fair comparison. We use the FID score only to evaluate the quality of the models in our experiments. So, we show in Figure 2 the progress of the FID score for COEGAN, COEGAN version 2, and the regular GAN approaches. We can see that COEGAN version 2 is able to outperform the original COEGAN model and also the solutions based on DC GAN. Furthermore, in the train-only phase, the discriminators and generators found by COEGAN version 2 are more stable than the ones found by the original COEGAN. COEGAN version 2 achieved in the last generation an average fit score of 24.8, which is 22% better than the best DCGAN approach. We test these findings and we show that the improvement of COEGAN version 2 over all other solutions is statistically significant. So, to summarize, we propose in this work COEGAN version 2, an extension of COEGAN that uses new techniques for GAMs to improve the model. Experiments show that COEGAN version 2 is able to outperform COEGAN and the regular non-evolutionary GAMs when training on the Fashion and Minis dataset. We also show that these results are statistically significant. For future work, we intend to further expand the model using other mechanisms like self-attention and also to evaluate the proposal in other datasets such as Cypher 10 and Celeba. Thank you.